when you encounter challenges in life. Sometimes that's the time that you will get the message from God. Sometimes kasi hindi ka masolo ng Diyos. Sometimes may gusto siyang gawin sa iyo, hindi ka niya masolo. You are so occupied. Pero ilalagay ka ni Lord doon sa sitwasyon na makikinig ka sa Kanya. In every situation, especially challenge to your faith, God has a very powerful message. If you miss the point, sayang ang pagkakataon. Pag ikaw ay naging Kristiyano, you are called for a battle. The moment the breath of God, which is the Holy Spirit, comes in your body, nabuhay ka. Pagkabuhay mo, that's the time, the day one of your battle. Pagka ang Kristiyano walang laban, hindi siya tunay na Kristiyano. Netflix is winning over devotion. Friends are winning over church services, over cell groups. Magbo-mobile legend ka over the church. You don't need to fight. You are already defeated. Paano mo ipagsasama yung kamay na gumawa ng karumal-dumal na sexual immorality at the same time magpapagamit ka ng tutugtog ka para sa Panginoon? Kahit anong gawin ng mundong ito. They changed the government. May pinoporn silang one world government. We don't have a problem because we have our own government. We have our own institution and constitution. It is the government of heaven that is where we are. You are not a citizen of this world. You are a citizen of heaven. As a Christian, your body is not controlled by blood, but by the Spirit of God. When you really face the real face of death, mararamdaman mo yan, matatakot ka. That is your greatest fear in life. If you know if you are dying, na wala ang puso mo sa Diyos. Nakakatakot, kapatid, kapag ang puso mo ay wala sa Diyos. Kaya huwag mong paglaruan ang pagka-Kristiyano mo. Ang sabi ng Bible, but you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. Ay, gusto ng kalaban, bumagsak ka. Why? He's interested in your power. Kapag ka tinanggap mo si Jesus sa iyong buhay, when you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, the same intensity of the Holy Spirit that descended to see Jesus is the same Holy Spirit that is in you and me. Do you realize your power? You are reading more what's going on in the Word than what is going on in the Scripture. He, the Holy Spirit, dwells in your body now. Kung may Kristo ka sa puso, and God's business is in this body. Pag may power ka sa buhay mo, sa katawan mo, sa pagkataon mo, that power will do something great in the kingdom of God. The government of this world cannot touch you. Why? Because you have the government of heaven in you. Sabi ni Jesus, someone touched me, I know the power gone out from me. That is what the Lord wants to tell you today, that you are a power bank. The Lord is recharging you now, and your faith is being developed. Every time there is an attack on you as a believer, you are being promoted. Kung daw ang grace ni God ay isang dagat, sana para akong bangka na lulubog. Ganyan patindi ang grace ni God.